activity am I doing? Supply of goods or supply of service? I am selling this laptop. No. Supply of goods. I am repairing this laptop.
Service.
Supply of service. So there is no confusion, yes or no?
Yes.
But hotel, you went to hotel having food?
Both.
But we don't have law, common law for both. So there is a law for goods, there is a law for service. There is no law for both. That both creates problem. Hello? And because that both have problem, section 71A, section 71A, whenever these two activities come together, goods and service, section 71A tries its level best to segregate. You go as the goods and you go as the service, because balance law, hello, balance law, section 10 onwards, there is a different law for goods and different law for service, and we don't have law for both. That means whatever hell you are doing in GST, you have to classify it either in the category of goods or in category of service. You cannot say it is both. Hello? Your activities must be classified either supply of goods or supply of service. Either supply of goods or supply of service. Now the shopkeeper here is not confused because he is selling Parle G chips and all. So what he is doing? Supply of goods. That courier company next to us. Service, they are not confused. We are classes. We are not confused, yes or no?
Yes.
But bike mechanic may be confused. Why? He is putting parts and he is putting labor.
Yes.
So he will be confused. Should I call it supply of goods or supply of service? Work contractor, this building contractor. I bought cement, bricks, steel, I'm constructing it. Yes or no? Is it supply of goods or supply of service?
Both
you cannot say, man, you have to select one. Select one. Either goods or service. Select one. Work contractor. I'm providing you. I'm constructing house for you. Are you getting this?
Yes.
I'm bringing my material. I'm bringing my labor. You have to classify. You have to give one tag. Goods or
service.
Give one tag.
Service.
You said service. In law it is written service. We took time to think about it. No.
Yes.
What is done by schedule 2? It has given us list. This activity consider as a service. This activity consider as a goods. Hotel.
Service.
You tell me, service or
service.
Goods?
Service.
You said service. Here also it is written as service.
Understood?
Understood?
Yes.
I gave you these goods. Gave you. Possession, ownership, both transfer. Supply of goods or supply of service?
Yes.
Supply of goods. But I gave it on higher. Higher. Are you getting this?
Yes.
You took goods only, no, from my shop. I gave you this laptop. So from my shop you are taking laptop only.
Yes.
But it is supply of goods or supply of service?
Goods.
Are potence, listen.
Service.
I sold you laptop, that is supply of goods.
Yeah.
I am giving you laptop for 10 days. From my shop you are taking laptop only.
Service.
But it is supply of
service.
Sir, are you getting? Although you are taking laptop only, but once you are taking as a ownership as well as possession, that is title is transferred.
Yes.
And in second situation, title is not transferred, only possession is transferred.
Yes.
Hello. So supply of goods with title is supply of goods. Supply of property without title.
Service.
Supply of service.
Yes.
In higher purchase. Have you heard word higher purchase?
Yes.
Thank you. In higher purchase, ownership is transferred on which date?
Last
date of installment. Yes or no?
Yes.
So if you have taken bike on loan or higher purchase, you will become owner on the payment of last installment. That means if there are 60 installment, you will actually become owner on 60th installment. Yes or no?
Yes.
But possession you will take today only, right?
Yes.
So today you are taking bike from my shop. I as the owner, I am confused. Title is not transferred now. Title will be transferred after 5 years. Yes or no?
Yes.
Should I call it supply of goods or supply of service?
Service.
Is it supply of goods or supply of service?
Service.
It is supply of goods because the title will be transferred. It's certain. Title will be transferred, but at the end of, like after particular period, in future, title will be transferred. You understood? There is a confusion, no?
Yes.
Still, we may get confused, isn't it?
Yes.
So there are three situations for goods. Supply of goods with the title.
Yes.
Supply of goods, you tell me, supply of property with title. Goods or service? Supply of goods with the title, ownership is also given today. This is supply of goods. Supply of this property without title.
Service.
Supply of goods, but title will be transferred in future date. Goods. So three situations are written in this cloth. Am I clear? Sometime it is goods, sometime it is service. That we need to check. So what is the job of section 71A? Section 71A is clearing our mind. This is goods, this is service. This activity is goods, this activity is service. So section 71A, activities shall be treated either as supply of goods or supply of service. Am I clear?
Yes.
Sure, up to here, no problem.
No.
Can I go ahead?
Yes.
So right now, till now I said we are in section 7. Section 7 is divided into three subsections: section 71, section 71A, and section 72. Section 71 is divided into three further clauses. Section 71A, where supply includes activities which are done in business, in the course of business or furtherance of business for a consideration. So B and C, both words are important, business and consideration. 71B talks about importation of service, importation of service for a consideration, whether or not in the course or furtherance of business. So B is missing, but C is there. Section 71C talks about deemed supply. Activities shall be treated as supply even though it is made without
consideration.
Even though it is made without consideration. The word, important word here is without consideration. And those activities are given in section schedule 1. Schedule 1 have 4 para. Para 1, para 2, para 3, para 4. Only 4 activities are there which can be treated as a supply even without
consideration.
Are you getting this?
Yes.
Sure. No confusion. Pakka?
Yes.
Section 71A talks about, in case of confusion, where both are involved, both components are there.
Yes.
In case of confusion, please refer to section 71A. Section 71A has already prepared schedule 2. Schedule 2 has divided activities either as supply of goods or supply of service to reduce litigation and confusion. Am I clear?
Yes.
Already it is. Logically also it will be service. But they have written legally it is service. Yes or no?
Yes.
So there is no fight now.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
Yeah? Section 72 is a blessing. Section 72 is a
blessing
which treat certain activity as neither supply of goods nor supply of service. And when the moment I say it is neither supply of goods nor supply of service, that means it is taxable or not taxable. Obviously it is not taxable. In other words, we call it negative list. We call it
negative
list means, okay, certain activities which are not taxable. Certain activities which are not
taxable.
Are you getting this? Certain activities which are not taxable. Like every day, your father or brother, somebody is there in your house, they get up every day, no matter what is happening in their life, they get up every day, they get ready and they go to do something every day. What do they do? Work. They go to
work.
Every day they go. Yes or no? Is it an activity? For a consideration?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Should it be taxable?
No.
Why?
It can be taxable.
Is it commercial activity?
Yes.
Yes or no? So commercial activity, working. But on employment, is there GST?
No.
Employee people are not paying GST. Why?
Income.
It's not like that. Because it is written in Schedule 3. The logic is, you don't give me your general knowledge logics. It is covered in Schedule 3. Schedule 3's first point is activities performed by employee to employer during the course of employment. During the course of
employment.
Therefore, crores of people who are working in India as of now are outside GST region. Hello? Otherwise, I told you they are also providing service, no? Employees are also providing
service.
Hello, employees are also providing service. So they could have brought to GST, no? But they are not. They are blessed by Section 72, Schedule 3. Section 72,
Schedule 3.
So these are activities which are not taxable. These are activities which are made by law. There is a purpose behind it. Obviously, there is a logic behind it. But legally, it is not taxable. Yes or no? All right. Court, when you go to court, court listen your plea, like whatever problem you are having, you put your issues into court and court will give you judgment. Yes or no? Do you think courts operate for free without charging anything? No, they charge fees. But we don't want that legal fees, court fees, or you know, justice in India should become costlier, should become. Therefore, we are not putting GST on it. Therefore, we are not putting GST. This is logic. Logic is not important. In law, it is written, court fees are covered under Schedule 3. Court fees are covered under Schedule. Activities performed by court are covered under Schedule 3. Schedule 3 means what? Court is neither supplying goods nor supplying service. And because it is neither, it's like security and money, you remember, no? Security and money is neither a goods nor a service. So therefore it is not taxable. So court fees, court activities, court services are neither treated as goods nor treated as service. Therefore it is not taxable. Similar employer to employer during the course of employment. One day you people will die. One day I will die. Everybody sitting here, one day we will die. From the birth, throughout the whole life, we pay taxes. This is what I told you. Maybe directly or? But we pay taxes. Will you be happy if government charges GST on your final rituals? So final rituals happens, no, in Samshan Bhumi or mortuary, crematorium. Hello? Transportation of deceased, you know, in ambulance they take dead bodies. It's passenger transportation only. It's like Ola Uber only, no? Only thing is passenger is dead.
Yes.
Hello? By default it is passenger transportation. So do you think or would you like to pay tax even after your death?
No.
Or should we get some benefit from government? Whole life I have paid taxes. At least allow me to die without tax. So, services performed by mortuary, transportation of deceased, crematorium. Crematorium means where they store this dead body. You know, in CID and all, you must have seen. Daya will go and then he'll open one refrigerator, one dead body will come. Kuch to gadbad hai. You know, so that house, that storage, that refrigerator services are not free. They charge money for it. Hello? But there is no GST on it. Why? Because it is covered under Schedule 3. Member of Parliament, Member of Legislative Assembly, President of India. Hello? These are constitutional bodies, yes or no? Constitutional people. They are performing constitutional functions. And they get money for it. But still it is not under GST. Constitutional functions are also covered under Schedule 3. Are you getting?
Yes.
Okay. In Mumbai, you must have seen some builders are putting advertisement on hoardings. Okay. No GST. Yes. Have you seen this advertisement?
Yes.
Don't you think it's something illegal?
Yes.
Because some builders are paying GST and some builders on board only it is putting. No GST. No GST means what? How can you say there is no GST? Is it a scam? No, because once building is constructed, once building is
constructed,
that building is covered under Schedule
3.
Constructed building doesn't have any implication of GST. But if you book flat under construction, then there is a GST. So builder who is putting add no GST, that means that building is
constructed,
or he will sell you building when it is constructed. Right now he will not sell. On kachcha bill, he will book your flat. Permanent booking will happen only when
building
is finally constructed and sold. Am I clear? He will not sell you building now. That is for sure. Are you getting this?
Yes.
Therefore, they have courage to put that on board. No GST. Otherwise, GST department can also see that, no?
Yes.
No GST. Let's go to his office. Hello? So, these are the active. Sale of land. Sale of land is also covered under Schedule 3. Because you don't construct land. Land is already there.
Yes.
You just sell it. On sale of land, we don't collect GST. Okay? So these are the certain activities that you need to remember. I just gave you a rough idea. Detail we have to discuss in law only. But I wanted to tell you what is the relevance of Section 7. Section 7 is divided into three subsections. Section 7.1, 1A and Section 7, subsection 2. Section 7.1 talks about supply includes three activities. 7.1A, business consideration. 7.1 B, importation of service for a consideration whether or not in the course of business. 7.1 C, certain activities performed without consideration which are referred in schedule 1, which are having 4 paras, yes or no, deemed supply, it's not actual supply, it is deemed supply. Section 7.1 A, certain activities either shall be treated either as supply of goods or supply of service to remove confusion. Section 7.2, blessings. Blessings, certain activities shall be treated neither supply of goods nor supply of services, therefore it is written in negative list, schedule 3. So technically what all is not taxable till now, from morning to now, whatever we have discussed, I told you there are certain act, we have to remember what is not taxable in law. So alcoholic liquor for human consumption is not taxable because it is excluded from 9.1. 5 petroleum products are not taxable because it is excluded by 9.2. Yes or no? So 6 item, money and securities are not taxable because it is excluded by section 2 clause 52 and section 2 clause 102. So 8 items. Yes or no? And now here we are having 5 items. Okay, almost 5 activities are there. Schedule 3 under section 7 subsection 2. So total these many activities are not taxable. Balance till now all other activities are taxable. Then now only last point I have to teach, and that is exemption. That is, once you understand exemption, there are almost 80-85 exemptions. Hello? After completing those 85 exemptions, everything rest in this world is
taxable.
Hello? Okay? Yeah, pause it.